Hey, what's up, guys? It's the weekend, you know, and I'm gonna do this video because another person asked for it and I said I was gonna do it. So it's the comparison between the MT10E and the Vkar Bison. Now, both these trucks are pretty nice. I'd say that is a fidget. This is kinda like the trend lately. My kids love it, so it's spinning right there. Anyways, those are the controllers. That's the size difference. The Bison is a little longer. First, let's look at the size. You know, so looking at the size, obviously the Vkar Bison is a little longer. It's a little bigger, it has a fin. And I think the Vkar Bison also has lights on the back, which the Bison, I mean, not the Bison, the Redcat doesn't on the back. So the MT10E might not. See those two little lights, like right there. This one only has them in the front. Let's turn it on so you guys can see. Alright, so here are the guts. The cool thing with the Bison is it also comes with this dusty shroud thingy. Kind of covers the dust, you could take it off, which is nice if you're gonna go for bashing. This is the inside guts of the MT10E. I'm gonna be running them both on 3S today. It comes with a little filter here to prevent dust from getting in too. It's a 4400 kV Thor motor. I think it might be 2-pole, but be honest, I don't know if it's a 4-pole motor, but it's pretty quick. It has a lot of low end. The only thing with the MT10E is it comes with a low speed pinion, so it's like, I think it's only like 9 to 11, something real small. So, comparing the two trucks, I think the MT10E has, it wheelies better. Like, you just pop that trigger and it'll shoot up, it'll backflip and stuff. The Bison can too, but you gotta click up the punch level, because when it comes in the box, and these tires kind of don't have grip. That was another thing I noticed. So if you floor it, it doesn't just shoot up and flip over like the MT10E. I think the MT10E, because of the way it's shaped and stuff, jumps a little better. Top end speed, the Bison has it. I mean, they clocked it about 45 to 48. Some people say 49. I don't know. You can feel it, though. Once it gets going, it's quicker, like top speed once it gets going. The Redcat has more acceleration, obviously. It's probably got a smaller pinion, and it just it's kind of fun if you just want to bash it, flip it, kind of like the... the Armor Outcast, you know, it's got that style to it. But looking at the shocks, I think the MT10E shocks are a little nicer. Let's look at the height level. So that's the height level right there. Wheel height, a little bigger on the Bison. They both got wheelie bars. I should turn this around, huh, so you guys get a better comparison. There you go. So that's the wheelie bar on this one. Versus the wheelie bar on that one. So another cool thing I wanted to show you is, well, this is, you know, the Bison, when you put the lid on, it kind of covers the on switch. Cool thing about the Redcat is the on switch is right here, so you can have it plugged in, go up to your bash site, and still be able to have the lid covering about just like that part, and then the switch is out here, which is kind of cool, so you turn it on. There's the headlights, so, yep, see, showing you guys, that's the back of the Bison, so you got those back LEDs. This one doesn't have it. Now, if you look at the front, there you go. So to me, and you guys probably want to know my opinion and which one I like more. So that's a tough one, because I think both trucks have its qualities that you'd want to get it for. The Bison runs about, you know, $275. You buy it from Asia. Sometimes it's in the US and you get it shipped, whether you get it on Amazon or you get it on Banggood or GearBest or whatever it is. I got it off that. It took a while to ship and get here. There's the shelves right there. But to me, I don't know. I think I enjoyed both of them, because I'm a speed guy, so I like them fast. But all I have to do is up the pinion on the Redcat, and it'll go super fast top end. You know, I'm in a Redcat group, and they got it going super fast. But I like it like one truck to like flip and do jumps and stuff and wheelie easier. And I think it just wheelies a little more responsively than the other one. Probably because these tires are better. They kind of grip a little better. This is kind of softer. This has a little of the foam filter. This tire is just better. You know, let me show you guys what the tire looks like. Look, yeah, see, it looks like that. You know, the Bison's got a little chrome finish to it like that. Okay. Oh, one more thing, real quick. So this comes with a 3S battery too, whereas the MT10E doesn't come with any battery. So you have to, you know, obviously supply your own battery. So you'll be paying. Yes, so value-wise, I'd say the Vkar Bison is better value-wise. It's a bigger truck. It's got LEDs already. It comes with a 3S battery. And by the way, the ESC is capable of 4S as well. Throw that in there, you're hitting about over 80 kilometers per hour, and it'll jump over 50 miles per hour. Whereas this one, I think it only takes 3S. You know, it's a max 10 ESE with that Fuller motor, which is cool. But value for value, piece for piece, when I actually took this car apart, because when it comes out of the box, the only bad thing about it is it just has there's problems. Okay, I'll tell you what the problems are. The Bison, the grub screw or whatever in this, like the pinion, it kept slipping. Like when I jumped it once, it slipped, so I had to tighten it, maybe put a little Loctite, it comes off. It's real easy to do. Whereas this one, it didn't have that problem, but it had different things. It's a drive cup problem. So there's drive cups. There's one like shaft that goes from the center, you know, gear to the back diff. And what happens is that drive cup, sometimes out of the factory, they don't Loctite it good. So it blew up and it kind of tore up the inside a little bit. One time when I just floored it. And that's a problem that people have been saying with the factory version. So when you get it, take it apart, check your lock pins on the drive cup, on the diff. I think mine was the back end. Yeah, the back end right there is the ESC. So it's very easy to take off. You just take it off, you unscrew these screws, pull this part, pull it off, and then there's a little drive cup, and Loctite it. Once you Loctite it, you're all good, and I haven't had any problems since. So that's been one of the problems with that. Bison, nothing broke, but just this little thing. But of course, you know, I just run it, speed runs and stuff like that. You can see my tires aren't even that dirty, but yeah, that's it. All right, so there it is again with the bodies on, and you know, I see how this one's all scratched up. So I did flip this one a lot because it flips a little easier. It just has a little more low end because obviously there's more acceleration because of the low pinion that it comes with. So factory had the box for both of them. That's how you get them. The thing I like about both trucks is these you know, pins, body pins. They're nice. They're easy to put in. Just they come out real easy. They're big. And they just feel easier to take off and on, which is pretty cool. But anyways, yeah, that's a look at both trucks, guys. Oh, and another thing, this body's a little thin. The Bison body feels a little thicker on this one. But I'm going to Gorilla tape the inside of this before I run it real quick and just make sure it's good to go. All right, there you go. Gorilla to go, trick to go. So what you do is, see, that's the inside of the body. So that those parts where they're scratched up a little bit, like right here, I just Gorilla tape the inside and kind of reinforce that area underneath. You know, that's what it looks like underneath. See, this thing's relatively thin, and I know it'll crack and stuff, and I've seen people do it. I haven't tried it yet, but bought this tape. It's pretty cheap, maybe like not even $3, because it's a small one, you know, just a little, just thick ones too. And there's like T-Rex tape too. I never tried that one, but let's do it. Ta-da! So what I did was, some people like do the whole insides, but I just kept it simple, you know, because if you look at where I usually land on, it's usually this corner, that corner, the back end, and then you got like the top part. See, that's all scraped up. So the first part we'll hit was this, and you know, the front does a little bit too, like right here, but maybe I should do that part too. But right now, when I backflip, mostly it's those parts. So what I did was I just did an inside layer like that. It actually makes the body feel a little heavier, a little sturdy, and that's it. All right, guys, so for sure, I'm gonna test the speed runs first. Let's just see how these things are running. So let's see. I'll start with the Bison. Let's see how this goes. That's the Bison, quick speed run, let you guys feel the power basically. Okay, now let me move this over to this side so that way I can run the Redcat. So the Redcat does about, 40 miles per hour with 3S. And it flips real easy, so I can't really accelerate fast. It just has a tendency to want to wheelie. I'm not even really doing full throttle.
just, you know, light half throttle to kind of ease into it, because this thing will flip like crazy. And it's nice on 3S though. This thing runs really well on 3S. Ease into it so it doesn't flip. Ease into it so it doesn't flip. I ain't about to scratch on my body like crazy. I've done that enough already, so gonna ease into it. Yeah, so yeah. Anyways, yeah, that's the MT10E, just a light running on there, guys. Alright, let's go just kinda run it a little bit, see how it willies a little bit. It, guys. Alright guys, so it's a beautiful day, Saturday morning. I'm at a different area today, but I take back what I said earlier about that little part. You could just stick your finger in here and turn it on, so it doesn't really matter between the on-off switch. But yeah, see, that's what I was talking about, but which is not as good like this, because sometimes it gets dirty and it gets messed up. But yeah, that's that. I'm gonna be running it here today. It's a beautiful day, you know, we got some grassy hills. Running around, and we got some straightaways, some hills, some grass, my usual spot way down there in the parking lot, doing cones and doing something over there. I'm not sure what it is, but alright guys, let's try the Vkar Bison first. I'm running 3S right here, so got a little dog over there chasing him. Anyways, that guys, that's a quick little run of how it is. Now you notice the Bison, it doesn't really willy unless you see, it doesn't really willy, especially with here. So whereas the Redcat, it willied like in a second. You saw it flip a while ago. But anyways, yeah. So I think if I adjust the punch level, turn up the change the tires, you know, these tires won't peel out as much. You guys felt the rocks hit us when I was peeling out of this. Anyways, there you go guys, a little quick run of this. Thanks for watching. I don't want to make this video too long. Anyways, peace and have a good day. Thanks for watching.